In this video, we're going to finish our parallel lines in Transversal's free KutaSoftware worksheet under the geometry section. And as always, there'll be a link in the description below so you know how to get to this worksheet. For numbers 19 through 24, our directions are to solve for x. Before we start number 19, let me quickly point out what we learned in the last video. We learned that corresponding angles are congruent, alternate interior angles are congruent, alternate exterior angles are congruent, and consecutive interior angles sum up to equal 180 degrees. So knowing this, we will be able to solve for x. In number 19, they give us this angle as 90 degrees and this angle as 21x plus 6. Those angles are both alternate exterior angles and therefore are congruent, which means they're equal in measure. So 21x plus 6 is going to be equal to 90 degrees. We'll subtract 6 from both sides of the equation. We'll have that 21x is equal to 90 minus 6, which is 84. When we divide both sides by 21, we get that x is equal to 4. So 4 is our solution in number 19. In number 20, you can see that 75 degrees is a corresponding angle to 11x minus 2. And since they're corresponding angles, they are congruent. So 75 equals 11x minus 2. I'm going to add 2 to both sides to get that 77 is equal to 11x, since my 2s will cancel out. My next step will be to divide both sides by 11, and I know that 11 goes into 77 evenly, and that's going to be 7 times. So 7 is going to equal x in number 20. In number 21, I'm looking at alternate interior angles, since they're both on opposite sides of the transversal and both in between those intersected lines. I know they're congruent since those intersected lines are indeed parallel. So I'm going to have 8x minus 4 equivalent to 60. I'm going to add 4 to both sides, and in doing so, my 4s will cancel out on my left, so I'll be left with 8x equal to 64. When I divide both sides by 8, I'll get that x is equal to a positive 8, since 8 times 8 is 64. In number 22, again, since my lines are parallel and since my angles are inside of those lines and are opposite the transversal, I know they are congruent. So I'll have x plus 139 equal to 132. My only step is to subtract 139 from both sides. When I do this, I'll get that x is equal to a negative 7. So negative 7 is my solution in number 22. In number 23, the angles I'm looking at are both opposite sides of the transversal and are both outside of the intersected lines. And since those intersected lines are indeed parallel, I know that these angles are congruent since they are alternate exterior angles. So I'm going to have negative 1 plus 14x, and that's going to be equivalent to 12x plus 17. I'm going to subtract 12x from both sides of my equation to get that negative 1 plus 14x minus 12x is going to be a positive 2x. That's going to be equal to 17. My next step, I'll add 1 to both sides to isolate the term with the x. I'll have 2x left on my left-hand side, and that's going to be equal to 18. When I divide both sides by 2, I'll get that x is equal to a positive 9. So 9 is my solution in number 23. And the last problem with this set of directions is number 24. In number 24, my angles are on the same side of the transversal, and they are on the same side of those intersected lines. Therefore, they are corresponding angles. And since my lines that are intersected are parallel, my corresponding angles are going to be congruent. So I'm going to have 23x minus 5 equal to 21x plus 5. I'm going to start by adding 5 to both sides. So I'll have that 23x is equal to 21x plus 10. Then I'm going to subtract 21x from both sides of the equation. 23x minus 21x is 2x. 21x minus 21x is 0. And I'm left with a positive 10. My last step will be to divide both sides by 2 to get that x is equal to 10 divided by 2, which is 5. My last set of directions say to find the measure of the angle indicated in bold. In number 25, my bold angle is this angle, x plus 96. Now you can see that the angles I'm giving information for are on the same side of the transversal and are also inside of the intersected lines. That means that those angles are consecutive interior angles, and since my intersected lines are indeed parallel, my consecutive interior angles will add to give me 180 degrees. So I'll have x plus 96 plus x plus 96 equal to 180. So what I need to do now is solve for x so that I can plug it back in to my bold angle. Simplifying, I'll have that 2x plus 96 plus 96 is 192. That's going to be equal to 180. When I subtract 192 from both sides, I'll get that 2x equals a negative 12. When I divide both sides by 2, I'll get that x equals a negative 6, since negative 12 divided by 2 is negative 6. Now I need to take my value for x, which is negative 6, and plug it in order to figure out my bold angle. So I'll take x plus 96, and my x is negative 6, so I'll have negative 6 plus 96, which I know is equal to 90 degrees. So 90 degrees is the measure of the angle indicated in bold. Number 26, again, I have consecutive interior angles, so I know that they're going to add to be 180 degrees. And that's because those intersected lines are parallel. So I'll have 20x plus 5, which is also my indicated angle, plus 24x minus 1, and that's all going to be equal to 180. Simplifying, 20x plus 24x is 44x. 5 minus 1 is a positive 4. And that's all going to be equal to 180. When I subtract both sides by 4, I'll get 176 on my right, and that's equal to 44x. Dividing both sides by 44 will give me that x is equal to a positive 4, since 176 divided by 44 equals 4. Now I can take that x, which is 4, and plug it in for my x in my indicated angle. So I'll have 20 times x plus 5, which I know is 20 times 4, since 4 is my value of x, plus 5, 20 times 4 is 80, and then I'm still adding 5, so my indicated angle is 85 degrees. In number 27, my angles are on the same side of the transversal, however, they are also on the same side of the intersected line. Therefore, as opposed to being a consecutive interior angle like my previous two, they are corresponding angles. And corresponding angles are congruent in measure when the intersected lines are parallel. So 6x is equal to 5x plus 10. I'm going to subtract 5x from both sides to get that x is equal to 10. Knowing that x is equal to 10, I can plug that value of x in for the x in my expression of that indicated angle. So 6x is going to equal 6 times 10, which is 60 degrees. So my angle indicated in bold is equal to 60 degrees. And the last problem on this worksheet, number 28. But before I go over this last and final answer, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Also, if you're confused on any part of this worksheet, feel free to comment below or go back to the previous video in which I describe everything more in depth. And number 28, since the intersected lines are parallel and my angles are consecutive interior angles, they are going to add up to equal 180 degrees. So x plus 109 plus x plus 89 equals 180. Simplifying, I'll have 2x plus 198, and that's going to be equal to 180. Since x plus x is 2x and 109 plus 89 is 198. I'll subtract 198 from both sides to get that 2x is equal to negative 18. When I divide both sides by 2, x will be equal to negative 9. So I'm going to take that value of x, negative 9, and plug it in for my x and my indicated angle. So x plus 89 will be equal to negative 9 plus 89, which equals 80 degrees. So 80 degrees is the measure of the angle indicated in bold. And just in case you forgot, here's a reminder to go ahead and click that subscribe button.